Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In our readings this weekend, we'll hear about the gifts that God has given us and how we're called to share those gifts as children of light. So as we prepare to celebrate the Eucharist, let's ask for God's guidance and wisdom in life so that we can properly use the talents, the gifts that God has given us. Lord Jesus, who gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, who come in word and in sacrament to strengthen us in holiness, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord our God, grant us the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good, not evil, all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hand to the distaff, and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor, and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive, and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief at night. When people are saying peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, for that day will overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of light and children of the day. We are not of the night or darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He said, Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I made 5 more. His master said to him, Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you are faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy. Then the one who received 2 talents also came forward and said, Master, you gave me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more. His master said to him, Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you are faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy. Then the one who received the 1 talent came forward and said, Master, I knew that you are a demanding person, harvesting where you did not plant and gathering where you did not scatter. So, out of fear, I went off and buried your talent in the ground. Here it is back. His master said in reply, You lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I did not plant and gather where I did not scatter. Should you not then have put my money in the bank, so that I could have got it back with interest on my return? Now then, take the talent from him and give it to the one with 10. For to everyone who has, more will be given, and they will grow rich. But from the one who has not, even what they have will be taken away. And throw this useless servant into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Throughout our journey of life, we get to a point when our parents, our teachers, and our friends might ask us to think about what we want to do in life. We're called to be aware of the gifts that we have and try to use them to the best of our abilities. And sometimes we might recognize those talents early in life, and for other times it might take people a while. For example, before he became a best-selling author of a number of history books on John Adams and Harry Truman, David McCullough was a high school teacher, and he really focused on history. In one of his books called You Are Not Special, McCullough tells a story of his high school students, and one of them called Jack. Jack was a quiet but responsible teenager. Jack is very bright, he's very attentive, but he really doesn't push himself. He made it through most of his classes with a B-minus, C-plus average. And all the teachers said throughout the school is that Jack could have done better. But one day, David McCullough discovered that Jack had a passion. Jack was able to draw. He was an artist, and he was really good at it. He created some pictures in a three-dimensional way. But he really focused on those areas in life in which he was interested. He formed paper models out of ordinary paper, maybe with also some pencils and scotch tape. And he created models of a sports car, of the Statue of Liberty, there's one of the Batmobile, and even one of Harry Potter's Hogwarts Castle. He first drew it, and then cut the image out of the paper, and using scotch tape, he put these models together. And so something, you know, drew his fancy. Jack would just simply sit down and create a model. And if it takes a week, it takes a week. And with that, David McCullough wrote in his book, Jack's gifts made me question, what's the image of an ideal student? You see, whether Jack goes on to be a successful artist or an engineer, it doesn't matter. He has learned something about passion, about focus, about doing something he loves and believes in. He knows the satisfaction of seeing with a purpose, and he dedicates himself to his ideas. And you know what? He produces good work. By doing so, he gains further confidence in his abilities, so he can create even more beautiful creations. And then also he can inspire others to use their gifts as well. You see, you don't always have to be the ideal student in school to share your talents in the world. It takes imagination, it takes courage, it takes wisdom, and a little bit of faith. That story about Jack is a wonderful example of using the talents that God has given all of us. Jack used his gift of being an artist through his various creations. And it begs us to reflect on the important question, what do we do with the talents that we have been given? Today's readings are focused on using the gifts that God has given us. In the first reading, it focuses on the worthy wife. Now, while that reading is often used at weddings, that reading can also be focused on the worthy wife, meaning wisdom. It's a wonderful gift that we need in life, the gift of wisdom. It says, wisdom is a great prize that's worth more than gold or precious jewels. It's more valuable than power, even more valuable than living a long life. Wisdom is the gift that God gives us to help us become successful in the world, especially when we use our wisdom to help others in life. In the gospel, we heard about the parable of the talents and those who use them. Now, in Christ's time, a talent is not what we call like right now, like playing the piano or singing. A talent was actually a form of currency. It was worth $1,000. So obviously a talent was not something you simply throw away. So the focus on the parable of the talents is on the servant who doesn't do anything with his talents, but it reflects not only who the servant is, but his lack of trust. He doesn't trust his master, and so he doesn't use the talents to make it even something greater. And so that lack of trust between the servant and the master is a reflection of our trust with one another and our trust in God. Christ says that God has given us so many gifts in our lives, but do we use them? Or out of fear, or out of ignorance, do we act like that last servant who simply puts their gifts, their talents, in the ground? Matthew uses that gospel to help us understand that we can't allow fear or ignorance to prevent us from being good disciples. We can't bury our talents. Sometimes we have to take a risk of using our talents to the best of our abilities without knowing what the outcome will be, because everything might not wind up in a perfect way. But we are called to be committed to using our gifts. Whatever our skills enable us to do, the challenge that Matthew gives us is to use our talents and help others grow as well, whether we can help them grow in healing, or compassion, or wisdom, and also faith. So we're called to use our talents in those different areas, and then by doing so, make our little part of the world a better place to live, whether it's at school, at work, at home, or in our community. So think about the talents, the gifts that you have in your life, whatever they might be. Maybe we can be a wonderful surgeon and bring healing, but we can also bring healing when we offer support to others when they're going through a difficult time. We might be a wonderful public speaker and people might follow us, but we can also be an influential speaker when we are there with others to help them along their journey. We might have the skills to be a wonderful manager of our business, but we can also have a skill to help others who might be in need. Maybe they need help financially, emotionally, spiritually, and maybe we can dedicate our time to a soup kitchen, a food pantry, or just helping out a local charity. So think about those gifts that you have in your life right now. Do we use them to the best of our abilities? Or do we keep them hidden somewhat, like Jack did early on? Can we share our talents with others? Maybe even just share a talent this week with someone we encounter. Whether it's the gift of compassion or wisdom, forgiveness or love. And then can we encourage others to use their talents as well? Well, let us try this week, next couple of weeks, to help others in the best way possible by using our talents. For when we take a risk and use our gifts, we can create some beautiful works of art. As a people of faith, we now profess our faith. Together, let us proclaim the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. At this time, This time we offer our prayers to our Lord. As children of the light, we look to God for our every need.
For believers who suffer persecution and for non-believers seeking truth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a world filled with peace and security, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community, as we strive to be faithful servants in God's vineyard, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased of our parish community and for the intentions of these mass, we pray. For Janine and Rich Festig, Andrea and Chuck Mastari, Phyllis Josephitz, Georgette and Bernard Bodens, Gloria Delpos, Jean Bosich, Char Hunter, Clara and Frank Bithover, Mary Ferran, Angie Cuevas, Katie Burke, Nancy Liptag, Jack Alfonso, and the parishioners of St. Alphonsus and St. Patrick Parish, and for the intentions that we hold in the silence of our heart, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of heaven and earth, we long to see your face. Hold us in your mercy and grant what we need. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Comes in the
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, her blessed husband, Saint Joseph, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise you and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For it is through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Right now, let's offer some sign of peace.
Thank you for those who have continued to support our parish. When you attend Mass, you may drop your donations in the collection box as you enter the church. Donations can also be made online via our website, or you can drop it off or mail it to the parish office. We appreciate your continued generosity. Now let the amount of people returning to church for Mass and other sacraments is growing each week, we are in need of more volunteers to help organize the various liturgies. We need volunteers as greeters, ushers for weekend Masses, baptisms, weddings, and funerals. Please contact the parish office for more information. Registration for the 9 a.m. Thanksgiving Day Mass at St. Patrick Church will begin this Monday, November 16th. You may register on our website or by calling the parish office. As a reminder, communion will be distributed after the final blessing.
Just one final note before our final blessing. As you might have noticed, a change in settings this week. We are at beautiful St. Patrick Church here in Lemont. Now that we are one parish, we'll try our best now to come to both sites, church sites, to celebrate our weekend Mass, recorded Mass as well. So we thank all those, our musicians, our cantors, lectors, for helping us record our Mass this afternoon. Let us please now offer our prayer at the communion, our final blessing. O Lord, you have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has ended. Let us go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.